Do you ever have the sensation that your phone's ringing, but when you take it out, you find that nobody was calling you? Or do you ever hear somebody call your name, but turn around and find there was nobody there? I'm Dr. Daniel Yon. I'm a psychologist, a neuroscientist, and a member of the faculty here in Birkbeck School of Psychological Sciences. Along with my lab, I study how our brains perceive the external world and also why sometimes our minds might play tricks on us. The problem that your brain has is that the world is a very uncertain and ambiguous place. The information that comes into the brain, the light that hits your eyes, or the sound waves that vibrate into your ears, they're just not good enough to create an accurate picture of what the outside world is like. Your brain, though, does have a solution. The solution your brain comes up with is it makes predictions about what the world is like. It's expectations about what's going on in that outside world. It mixes in those expectations into your perceptual experiences. This is usually a good idea. Usually mixing in what you expect into what you perceive will make perception better, because what you expect usually does come true. But it can be a bad thing, and it can cause us to misperceive if we expect the wrong thing. For example, if, like me, you wear glasses, you might expect that when you put on your frames, you'll begin to see the world more clearly. And usually that expectation will come true. But you could imagine there's been a mix-up at the opticians, and so now these frames contain the wrong lenses. If that were true, I might put them on, still expecting to see the world more clearly, but actually find I'm just as blind as I was before. We run experiments like this in the lab, where we have volunteers put in different situations where they expect to see the world more clearly, or they expect it to be more ambiguous and more blurry. What we find is that these expectations can reshape the experiences that they begin to have. If people are expecting the world to be clear, they tell us that they're more confident in what their eyes are telling them, or that the things they're looking at really have become more vivid and crisp. But this is just an illusion. They can't really see the world more clearly. Their brain is telling them that they can see things that objectively they can't. Indeed, if we put people inside the brain scanner here at Birkbeck while they're doing these kinds of experiments, we find that these kinds of expectations can reshape activity in the perceptual centers of the brain, nudging it towards what we initially believed. In a very real sense, the brain begins to see what it believes. We think that this kind of research is very important for understanding how all of us perceive the world, but it could be particularly important for understanding psychiatric illness. For example, in psychotic illnesses like schizophrenia, a very common symptom is hallucinations, where people see or hear often threatening things that aren't really there. There's now an emerging picture where we can think of these kinds of experiences as arising from an atypicality in the brain mechanisms we use to make these predictions. By too strongly projecting what we expect into what we experience, we begin to perceive things that aren't really there. In the end, understanding these mechanisms in the mind and brain will help us to understand how all of us perceive the world, but the hope is it will also give us a way of improving these unusual experiences too.